Chelsea were a case in point. Rumours of dissent in the dressing room, half the team asking for transfers, including Kerry Dixon. Dixon lost his goal-scoring touch and then his England place. But now John Hollins says the Chelsea ship has moved into calmer waters. He sold and spent well over £500,000 on Kevin Wilson, a striker from Ipswich, and attacking defender Tony De Rigo from Aston Villa. And the optimism is maintained with keeper Eddie Nesvici fit again after 18 months of injury. So Chelsea are hoping for a start this season that reflects their new ambition. But they kick off under threat from the property speculators. Ken Bates, the Blues chairman, has launched a £15 million fund to buy the site for football, but Supermac believes the football might also continue to struggle.
Whether or not Chelsea's defence are going to be strong enough and their midfield creative enough to back up Dixon's promises, I think that's a question that only the season will give the answer to, but my own little feeling is that it might not be good enough.
It was all change at Queen's Park Rangers last season, where David Bulstrode took over as chairman from Jim Gregory. The talk of sellouts and mergers caused the team's performance to slump, and Rangers narrowly avoided the playoffs. But following a big player clear-out this summer, Paul Parker and Dean Coney have made the trip from Craven Cottage to Loftus Road. Jim Smith has further strengthened his squad with last night's move for Kevin Brock. It's the last season on plastic for Rangers, which is good news as far as Supermac is concerned.
Consistency is certainly lacking there at Queen's Park Rangers, and I feel that the pitch at Loftus Road doesn't help Rangers at all. They lose a lot of games at home, and yet they get quite a lot of good results away from home.
Fulham went to the brink and back last season. They nearly merged with Rangers as the club went through its most traumatic season ever. There was furious reaction to the proposal, which would have led to Craven Cottage being developed. Eventually, a consortium led by Jimmy Hill bought the club. Well, that sparked a revival amongst the players, who narrowly avoided relegation. But Supermac believes the news off the pitch will continue to dominate.
I think the headlines that are caused in West London will again be about property, not about the success of any of the three football clubs, I'm afraid. It's going to be a Marla wrangle with Bates, a Marla wrangle with Jimmy Hill, and so it will go on. And quite what's going to happen at Loftus Road, who knows now. I think, though, that it will be Marla headlines, unfortunately, not the success of the football teams.